Welcome back, peeps. We are going to be building up another fun one. It's Buick week on the channel, I guess. It's Buick stock car week on the channel, we'll call it. This brand new package in from AMT, Ups just dropped it off on my porch, is the 66 Buick Skylark Modified Stocker. Now, I've built numerous of these modified stockers. I enjoy every one, so every single one that shows up is going to get a build. I enjoy them. Got the whole series. I've even posted pictures of these cars on the hpiguys workshop Facebook page. You can always check those out. A lot of people had said, oh, these tires are too unrealistic, they're not really, and I found pictures of cars just like this with the Nerf bars and these massive tires sticking out from the fenders, and posted them on Facebook to say, yes, they actually exist, and they actually run cars with tires that big for the frame. So we're going to get this one all built up. They talk a little bit about the Galaxy and the Ford Fairlane. I've built up some of those on the channel and others. Let's start taking a look at everything that'll be in the box when you get yours. First up, we've got our mega simple interior. It looks like there's a back seat in there, but if we get nice and close, we can see that that's all supposed to be metal, all covered up with rivets. The door panels are covered up with rivets as well. Now, the rivet counters will love that. They love counting all those. We've got our floor with our three pedals. And then it is blank on the bottom. We've got a chassis here, which a lot of you will be very happy to see, is completely blanked out of exhaust or anything like that. It's just got the suspension, cross braces, drive shaft, and differential with links. And the bottom of the trunk there are the fuel tank. We can see where it used to be screwed together back in the day. But yeah, they didn't mold the exhaust in this or anything. They cleaned that all up so that it doesn't look like a regular vehicle. Got the fenders built into the inside of the chassis there. On this tree, we've got our Buick motor. I'm not sure what size engine. It just says Buick engine, so they don't know either. So you guys can tell me in the comments. I always like learning when you use constructive criticism. We've got our engine, we've got carburation on there, water pumps, we got intakes. Looks like we can do a single carburetor or multiple. All the way across there, that kind of looks cool, I'll probably use that. We've got our headers, we've got manifolds on there, belt and pulley system, battery, little tiny oil pan. That's adorably small, obviously because the axle is going to be going through the front of the motor. Old style kit there. We've got our roll cage with padding molded in. And more of that there. That's kind of neat. It's like a corrugated padding. It's interesting. We got our firewall with our heater core on there in case it gets cold on the track. Got body parts, got wheel studs. There's not a ton of parts in the kit, but we're going to make, there's not a lot of parts to a stock car either. Got our dashboard, and the dashboard is non-factory and has some very faint gauges. We'll have to work on those in the video. Steering wheel, the steering wheel is wrapped. We've got our wheels, which are just basic steelies, extra wide with our wheel backs there. Glue those together, that's just one entire tree. We've got our racing seat, which does have belts molded in. We've got our hood. Hood pin molded in. Smaller wheelbacks. We got part of our bumper system in the front there. And we've got the big old Skylark body. Radiator support built in, belying its old promo style. Nice smooth molding. We got some trim along the bottom, which maybe we could paint that in. They might have left some of it on. Waited for it to get ripped off. Figured I'd do a little Nerf capability. No door handles or anything. No windshield wipers. Got our vent in there though, because they wouldn't fill that in. So it's a nice looking body for a stock car. We'll go around the other side. We will grab the new and improved decal sheet. We got all kinds. This says Crazy Ed in white. Fireball, Bobby Joe. We got some sponsor logos. Bernie Salvage. We got some nice number plates on there. I like the one made out of duct tape. That's cool. It looks like that, but look at it close. It's duct tape. Little details. Runny spray paint. All these cool little logos. Little smiley faces. Little Punisher logo. It's not the real Punisher, you know. Too much for the license, but there's your decal sheet for this one. We've got two steel axles. We've got a single piece of glass for the windshield. We've got a nice set of chrome here. Of course, the headlights will be completely blanked out. Steel wheels. Use these as spares with those wheel backs. Chrome fan. We got some velocity stacks on this one for that intake. Custom valve covers. Tail lights with the tail lights blanked out. That's it for our chrome. And then to wrap it all up, we've got those massive pad-printed Goodyear tires. They're two-piece tires, but you really don't know. You don't even have to glue these. I've been using these the entire time, and they press together really slick. You can see. You really don't notice. They look awesome. They sand beautifully, and they are those big, giant fatties. Finally, in the instruction manual, it lets you know, like I've done on some of the other builds, if you want to do a dirt track, you just hex in a pattern. You can see this one's done as a dirt track, and they've got the pattern drawn in on the cool box art. So you can do that, or you can just sand them smooth as a pavement racer or hard pack dirt if you don't want the treads. So I'm going to start gluing my modified stocker together, and I'll be right back. Well, that doesn't take long at all. As you see, extremely easy buildup. We're not going to struggle with anything. We've got the alternator and the power steering pump, which is interesting to have on a kit like this. A power steering pump hanging off the side like that, usually, you know, be a lot less detail, but that's pretty awesome. So we can paint that up, and then everything else on this tree, just the air cleaner and the headers and the battery. Pretty much, we're not going to be using the high-rise intake on a stock car, but you have that now with those chrome pieces to install on any other vehicle you want, or you can use that Buick motor in another car for you to build. The Nerf bars for the side and the bumper, we're going to be painting those up separately and getting those on the car towards the end of the build. The wheels, the tires are too solid and too thick to glue the wheels together back to back and then shove them through. But the tires are definitely solid enough that we can just paint the wheels separately and then push them through on the car, and they will fit perfectly. They shouldn't fall off at all, and they will be held in place with the steel axles. So we're not going to have any issues with that. The dashboard and the steering wheel, we can get painted up. Then we will accent our gauges. Still trying to get you a view of those. They're on there. They're just, there we go. They're just super shallow, but they are in there. So you can see how that's going to come out. Got that Buick motor there. Got our manifold. We're going to be putting our valve covers on. But I got the stocker style intake with the carburetor, glued the distributor onto the back, got our oil filter on there, and this will actually have brackets for the alternator and the power steering. Isn't that cool? Right on the water pump, it's all one piece like that. And you can paint that engine any color you want. You can look up what a 66 Skylark engine, what color it would be. But since this is a race car, they could have yanked this out of anything from any era that would have had that Buick motor in it. So don't worry about factory perfect. I never worry about factory perfect colors anyways, but that's how it is. This little part here is actually the shifter boot, or the transmission for the tunnel there, the mount for the shifter. So you can paint that any color you want. I want it contrasting the interior. I did glue the motor mount in. It's very easy to tell where it goes because it's got some detail from the suspension arms already in it. So you'll make sure you orient it the correct way. Other than that, that's ready to go with just some basic paint and detail. The seat's ready to go. We'll get that painted up. The interior, you saw me build the roll cage right inside of it, and then it'll be separate, and we'll be able to paint all that roll cage material, the padding, very distinct, so we can do things in two different colors. Maybe do like a primer gray on the bars, and then we'll overpaint it again with some black or whatever we decide. You know, you don't have to use black cushioning. You could use colorful cushioning on there. On the body, I had videotaped this whole thing about putting dent in the body. And when I offloaded the videos off my GoPro, it wasn't there. So either I didn't tell it to record, or the file was corrupted or something, but I can explain what I did. So you can see on here, I've just got some dents in the body. That's a little more damage on this side, but nothing on the quarter. You can see it's just a little wavy. It's more realistic. I don't want to completely trash the car. All I did was take a pocket lighter, a Bic lighter. You don't have to be brand loyal, but whatever. Warmed up the inside, hovering in the flame underneath it, and just took my thumb to make creases. A lot of these bodyworks will have a sharp crease in them. So I just pushed it in and dented it in and messed with it. This side got a little more roach than I wanted it to, but that doesn't matter. So we'll mount the Nerf bars on there. This could have been a dented up, banged up car that they converted into a race car. We could bend one of the Nerf bars towards some of those dents to say they happened in race, or anything. We can make up our own story, but these things usually, that's why they have Nerf bars on them. These things usually take quite a beating out on the track. So, and they're out, you know, they're built from older cars that were probably a little damaged up or whatever before they end up as stock cars. So we make up our own stories as we go just to have fun. I'm gonna get all this stuff over into the paint booth, and I will see all you cool folks over there. Thank you.
Thank you.
the project so far. Couldn't be going much easier. These are very, very, very simple kits to work on. You can do anything you want. That's why I wanted to add some dents and some bang-ups and rust the chassis a little bit with some paints and just have fun with it in a good time. The decals all slide on easily. I made sure these are duct tape decals. I made sure not to apply them perfectly straight. The guy's just slapping them on so he can go racing. He's got a couple sponsors there, Steve's Engines, Bernie Salvage. That's his two uncles. That's the only way he could get a sponsor. So we got those on there. Got this side on a little straight, but the two isn't quite on there right, and that's the way I want it to look. Those decals were so awesome. Scratched up the bodywork. That's why it's in the salvage yard to begin with. Couple dents and bangs on it, but it was good enough to run. I did chrome and then black wash the hood scoops on there, the air intakes. We got our grill in there, and I did flat coat the bumpers so that they weren't super shiny chrome. By the time they made it to the racetrack, they wouldn't be all in excellent condition, or the car probably wouldn't be there. We've got our Nerf bars here, which I will attach once the whole car is together. I haven't banged those up yet. He's just getting ready to run the track. This is a new car for the season. By the time the season's over, those things will be all bent and rusted. They're just bare metal tack welded together to hold the sides of the car together. We've got our interior, super duper simple. You saw how I did those gauges so that they would at least stand out. We've got our steering wheel. I did the seat in red just so we wouldn't be all black and silver interior, and it looks nice. I used the same red that I did on the engine that you saw. Make it look nice, accentuated the belts, got our shifter in there, and our nice roll cage. Everything's glued into place. That will just pop into the interior right up in those pins there. So that's going to be pretty easy to work on. And then we've got our exhaust on. The headers don't even line up coming out. That's fine. They probably wouldn't care. But getting them onto that engine, I had to drop them in and bring them out next to the suspension arms. And they were kind of difficult. So I glued them in the best I could against the engine. It's really a hard fit in there with those. And then glued our engine in place. Belt and pulley. Had the fan be metal on this one. Probably a replacement. Love those brackets off the side. Actually make it look a little more real. Painted the carburetor, distributor, and our Buick Wildcat engine. Got those massive meats on there all the way around, and you saw how I sanded those down. Final assemblies, really don't have to do anything else except put the interior in the body, snap the body on. I will then glue in the battery, the air cleaner, and the little side mirror so he can catch guys coming up next to him. Get the Nerf bars on the car, get them glued in place, and you don't have to use these. Not everybody running out on those stock cars is using Nerf bars, but you can put them on there if you choose, which I will. And then I will have that final in just a moment. Now, I've built more than one of these. I've built quite a few of AMT's modified stockers, and they are never a difficult build. You can always do what you want with them. You can build them as you want. You don't have to use the Nerf bars. You could put different wheel and tire combos on them. You can do anything you want. You could build these into like a slot car using the body and race it around the track with those wheel openings and all that. So when you get yours, you should do what you want. Now, I chose to use, of course, the duct tape decals and the ones that would show up on a blue paint job. But don't forget, you got a lot of nice stuff left over. You got some cool numbers. You got some cool names. You got green flames and some sponsor decals for any other kit later. I will put up the pre-order information on this kit as soon as it's available. So if it's not in the description today, when the video comes out, it'll get on there eventually. We'll have it ready for you. So no problems at all putting this kit together. I had no issues with fit, finish, nothing. It goes together so easy. It's pretty much a fantasy vehicle. The modified stockers are a thing in the real world, but these aren't really based off of something that existed in the real world. They took an existing body, chassis, modified it as they need to make these cool little model kits. And like I said, I've pulled up pictures on the Facebook page that show you that these giant tires sticking out from the fenders cut into the body like that are historically accurate. There are cars that run like that, that look like that, and I've posted pictures of them. You can see underneath on this one, the body does go on really nice, and I didn't have to glue it in place. It just pushes in with those old studs. With the promo style, we can see our basic underneath, and they didn't leave a stock chassis on it, so there's no exhaust hidden on there. It really is for the modified stocker, so it looks awesome. The Nerf bars I attach with just some thick gel super glue right there, right from the dollar store, and or the dollar and a quarter store now. And those hold on. I know some of you, you can't glue on chrome, you can't glue on paint. It works just fine. Unless you're going to be using your models or transporting them a lot, really kind of moving them around and banging them around and stuff. Otherwise, there's stuff on there forever. I did attach the rear view mirror. I thought it'd be a neat touch for the race car driver to see who was coming up on his inside corner, and then gave it some small weather details. Did those dents, as in that's how it found its way to the Bernie salvage to be used as a race car. Scratched inside those dents. You saw how I did it in the details section of the video. Made everything go along just fine. This, of course, there is absolutely no way you could build a stock 66 Skylark from this car. Absolutely none at all. The engine looks cool. The engine is modified to fit around that metal axle, but if you just stuck a regular oil pan on it, you should be able to use that in other vehicles as well without a problem. Or if you didn't mind that it had that hump in it, you could use it in anything you wanted. I did the interior up in my own way, made it look kind of neat, made it kind of look like sheet metal coverings with the dashboard, show you how to get those gauges painted. The windshield just falls in place, held in with some gloss Mod Podge. I get asked in the comments a lot of times, what Mod Podge would you use? I use gloss, of course. It's for glass. Glass should be glossy and clear, and that's what it is there. And of course, you could modify that. You could put some cracks in it from the track. You could put some dirt on it. You could carve out grooves on the tires, make it a dirt track car. I've done that with one of these, made it a dirt track car and enjoyed doing it. This one I left on the pavement. I just thought it would look neat as it is zipping around the track. So as always, thanks to Round 2 Models for sending over this kit from AMT. Thanks to my cool viewers. I will link down in the description where you can snag yours as soon as the links are available. And I will see all of you at the next review.